What's shaking, baby? The Blue Podcast, episode 63. Diary of a Song, part 12. L-Y-S-Y-S. Something Nick and I text each other. It means love you, see you soon. I think that originated from this girl I dated in high school. Is it bad to call women chicks? I don't think it is, man. I think people get what you're saying. Be like calling a guy a bro. Or a dude. Probably a dude. That's probably more like it. Would you call a girl a bra? There's an episode of Seinfeld about that. The man's ear. No, it should be called the bro. Dude, I love Seinfeld. Such a good show. Anyways, love you, see you soon. This one was made in a Walmart parking lot in Iowa, I believe. And that's where it started. It probably started somewhere else, but I remember taking a video and working on it for a second in a Walmart parking lot back when Ann and I were traveling to Colorado. So this was made around the same time as Without You, I'm Not All Right. And it was released in, drumroll please, on July 7th, 2023. So just under a month after we got married. It was probably finished before then. But here, so I was under the impression that I had to do a song every X amount of weeks. So I wanted to get this one out. It's probably my favorite cover art. It might be one of my least favorite songs out of all of them. Now, if you love it, I'm not trying to deter you from listening to it. By all means, there's a slowed and reverbed, a sped up version. Go ahead and check them out. There's an official audio visualizer on YouTube. You should check that one out too. But, you know, that's just me promoting myself. You know what I'm saying? I don't know why I called it that. I think that's just what I was feeling, and I put it out. In retrospect, I don't know. It's best not to be the judge of your own work. But this was the second of three until I hit a point, because there was a fourth one that I was going to make, and then Nick and I had to talk about it, and I was like, I don't really get much joy out of these songs, but I learned a lot. And I think the value in just making something and putting it out can't be understated, because then you can, like, I might not like this song, but the lesson I'll learn from this song is far greater than my dislike for it. So it really doesn't matter if you like or don't like it to a point, but definitely loving something and liking it will give you the best result. Sometimes, or sometimes people will just love something you made and you absolutely hate it, but then guess what? That's what you're gonna sing every night, and it's totally worth it. I don't think that's selling out. I think that's just, you know, adopting the correct mode of humility, which would be something that I definitely learned after making this song. And I really like that it's titled... Oh, sorry, I hit the mic there. I really like that it's titled after what Nick and I would text each other. I think that's about all I got on this one. This is a pretty short one. But hey, it's a pretty short song. It's 2 minutes, 16 seconds. All the more reason for you to go check it out, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, these three, this one, and then, what is the next one called? Don't tell me. I'll tell you. You probably don't even know what I'm talking about. Kinetic Aesthetic. So this one, all of them had pretty important meanings in the name. And they were just inspired. I had just discovered Fred again. Man, that guy is so good. And he's so good at what he does, and he's so singular with it. It's awesome. I love Fred again. He actually isn't that singular. He's produced a lot for other artists, but that's what these were inspired by, and they're really cool. And they add a little bit of flavor. I was going to make 10 of them and just have it be like an extended version of the Blue Light, because I also liked the Paradise Edition, which is an extended version of Lana Del Rey's Born to Die. Lana Del Rey. Lana Del Rey. Lana Del Rey. Lana Del Rey. But I ended up just making 3 of them and then continuing on with Feral 57, which is what I should have done to begin with. But it took doing this to learn that, so you know what I'm saying? It will all come out in the wash. Huh. Well, that's about all I got for this one. I think I've said that like 7 times already this episode, but thanks for listening in. I will let you know when Anne gets back from the supermarket. I very well may be recording an episode when she does get back. But until then, keep listening, keep creating, and as always, D-Homework! Ain't no way. Diddy in a day, mofo better come out here and show me, ain't no way, way, diddy in a day, mofo better come out here and show me, damn!